Hello everyone, welcome back to the Chemical Engineering at Aspen channel. And as you know, these days we are focusing on the module of Chemical Reaction Engineering. So in this regard, we are bringing the lecture number 12 for our valuable viewers. So in today's course coverage, we will again talk about the building block number 2, which is the rate law. And in fact, this is the last lecture on this building block. Obviously, incorporation of the building block will be considered in stoichiometry, isothermal design and heat effects, but a detailed discussion or a detailed lecture on this building block is presented here to the valuable viewers. So in the last lecture on this building block, we will first discuss some rate concepts. Then we will move to the Arrhenius plot from the Arrhenius equation. And then we will solve an example. And finally, the concluding remarks related to this building block. So there are three concepts which need to be considered while we are discussing the rate law and our building block number 2. Number one concept is that the rate increases with increase in the concentration of the reactants. Obviously, we have seen the rate equation as minus Ra is equal to KC if A is a reactant. So minus Ra, which is the rate, and CA, these are directly proportional. So that concept is met over here. For the second concept, the rate is related to the potential barrier height and to the conversion of translation energy to the potential energy. This concept involves the activation energy, and activation energy, as we have discussed before as well, that higher the value of activation energy, the more will be the barrier for the system, and accordingly the barriers would be different for exothermic and endothermic reactions. Again, the rate is related to the potential barrier height and to the conversion of translation energy to the potential energy. The more it will be, the more will be the rate. And finally, the concept number 3 is that with the increase in number of collisions, the rate increases, because with the increase in collisions, the energy is provided, the sufficient energy to cross over the barriers and to form products is increased with the increase in collisions. So accordingly, the rate is directly proportional to the number of collisions. Now we had seen that KAT, which is a function of temperature, is equal to A E of minus E over RT. In the last lecture, we had seen that this is an Arrhenius equation and it is used to predict the value of rate constant. Now taking the natural log of that equation, what it will become? Natural log of KA is equal to natural log of A minus E over R into 1 over T. Now if you see here that this one, we call it as Arrhenius plot. We will say it as Y, we will say it as M minus E over R, X, Y is equal to mx plus c. So once we draw a plot between 1 over t at x axis and natural log of Ka at y axis, then we get the slope as minus e over r and the intercept as natural log of A. And accordingly, we predict the values of A and E. And once the values of E and A are known, we put it over here and we finally get the value of K as well. Another way of doing it, that we plot between 1 over t and k, and the trend line from the axle will give the direct value of A and E. To understand this, in a couple of minutes we will go to the Excel sheet and we will see it. The larger the activation energy, the more temperature sensitive will be the reaction. That is, for the large value of activation energy for a system with an increase of few degrees even in temperature can greatly increase the value of the rate constant. And with the increase in the value of rate constant, the rate of reaction will increase. As we have seen, that rate of reaction is directly proportional to the values of concentration of reactant as well as the rate constant. So accordingly, the rate constant could be increased by increasing the temperature, because it's a function of temperature. And how it could be possible? Because for the systems having large value of activation energy, this could happen. So finally, moving to our class activity, that calculate the activation energy for decomposition of benzene, diazonium, chloride to give chlorobenzene and nitrogen. And the information of K and T is given. K is the rate constant, T is the temperature. And we have to calculate the value of activation energy. So we will be using both Arrhenius plot and relationship, as we have seen in the previous slide, that we had drawn K at y-axis, 1 over T at x-axis. And we had directly calculated the value. So we will use both relationships in Excel. So going to the Excel and solving it. So now we have been given the data that the values of K and temperature are given. The value of K is in 1 per second, while the value of temperature is in Kelvin. Now we will first use the Arrhenius plot. What does the Arrhenius plot say? That natural log of K is equal to natural log of A minus E over R 1 over T. or we can simply say it as y is equal to c plus mx, where c is natural log of a and m is minus c over r. So what we need to do, we need to first calculate natural log of k and 1 over t. So natural log of k is natural log of these values, and the answer is given over here, and 1 over t. So accordingly, simply 1 divided by 312.5, or accordingly all these values, and then picking these two values to draw the graph between these two, and then adding the trend line from here, and we got the trend line as y is equal to minus 14018x plus 37.123, and r square is equal to 0.9998. So accordingly, you can see y is equal to mx plus c. So the value of m is minus 14018, or m is represented as minus e over r, where the value of r is 8.314. So accordingly, the value of e will be 116.5457 kilojoule per mole. Similarly, the value of c is 37.123, and actually that c represents natural log of a. So accordingly, the value of a will be, taking exponential on both sides, so it will be 1.33 multiplied by 10 raised to power 16, and the unit will be 1 over second. This is the one way of doing it, and to find the value of activation energy and to find the value of A, which is the pre-exponential factor in the Arrhenius equation. Another way of doing it, that we take K, which is this one, and 1 over T, which is this one. 1 over T at x-axis, K at y-axis, and accordingly again drawing the trend line will be the exponential line, because we see that it is k is equal to a e of minus e over rt. So we will in trend line choose the exponential line, and I have already shown you the procedure to draw the trend line. So accordingly, what it will be, y is equal to 1.32 multiplied by 10 raised to power 16 e of minus 1.4 multiplied by 10 raised to power 4x. So if you see here, this line is represented like this, that 1.33, approximately 1.325 is its answer. So it will be 1.33 multiplied by 10 raised to power 16 exponential of minus 14018 over t. So this is how, this is the second method how you can derive it, where here the x will be 1 over t, y will be k, 1.33 e of minus 14018, that will be the value of e over r in the system. So that's how you draw, or that's how you compute by graphical method the values of the factor given in the Arrhenius equation, which are these factors, the exponential factor, activation energy, and accordingly you can see that by both ways we have computed it. After solving this example, coming to the concluding parts or the last derivation for this, that at temperature T, we know that Ka at T is equal to A, which is a pre-exponential factor, exponential of minus E over RT, this E is the activation energy. If we know the value at some reference temperature T naught, accordingly this expression will become that this T is replaced by T naught, and this T is replaced by the T naught. So once we divide both these two, this A will cancel out with this A. This will become as KAT over KAT naught. This will become exponential of minus E over RT over exponential of minus E over RT naught. Once you rearrange it, you get this final equation as K of A at some temperature T is equal to the value of k at reference temperature exponential of e over r 1 over reference temperature minus 1 over the actual temperature. It means that if we know the value of rate constant at some temperature T naught, then we can find the value of k at some other temperature if we know the value of activation energy at that, definitely that temperature. So that's the last derivation for this chapter, and there is often a misconception, or we have studied in our previous courses, that we said that there is a rule of thumb that for every 10 degree centigrade increase in temperature, the rate of reaction doubles. However, this is not always true, and not always true for all combinations of activation energy. However, it is true for specific combinations. What are these combinations? For example, if the activation energy is 53.6 kilojoule per mole, the rate will double only if the temperature is increased from 300 to 310 Kelvin. Similarly, if the activation energy is 147 kilojoule per mole, then this rule that for every 10 degree centigrade increase in temperature, the rate is doubled, that will be valid if the temperature is increased from 500 Kelvin to 510 Kelvin. If it is increased from 510 to 520, that rule will not valid. And how you can see it? You can see problem P39B in the book Elements of Chemical Reaction Engineering by H. Scott Fogler, for the derivation of this relationship. So at the end of this, we are concluding the building block number 2, which is the rate law. I hope you have liked the lectures related to the building block number 2. And if you have any query related to this building block, you can ask by giving your comment in the comments box or even your suggestions, your feedback for the improvement. So that's it from this lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Also click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned for more exciting videos of this channel.